Guitars fun to play. Hey guys, Dagan here from PMTV UK, and this is the brand new FSR Fender Special Run Squier Custom Esquire. I love Esquires, single pickup Telecasters. It seems like the harder you hit them and the more you let them ring, the better the sound. They're just absolutely awesome, and they've nailed it with this new Squier. It's a 60's custom, so it is an Esquire. Esquires came about in the early 50s, well, in 1950, and this was the precursor to the Broadcaster, which was then the Telecaster. If you want to know more information like that, watch the video linked in the description box down below about some awesome facts about the Telecaster that you didn't know. But this guitar is that Esquire single pickup Telecaster, but with the custom 60's aesthetic. So it's double bound, no contouring or anything, one single pickup, and it just screams. It's just a joy to play. So there is a pickup, well, firstly, I'm gonna apologize because black guitars are my favorite, but boy, do they love fingerprints. So apologies if it's a bit fingerprinty, this guitar. It comes in black with the cream binding, also blue with binding, and sunburst, also with binding. It's just that sleek, stripped back tuxedo look about the double bound custom Telecasters, which really gets my juices flowing. And the fact that it's an Esquire as well just blows my mind. So the specs on this bad lad: Nato body and a bolt-on maple neck, and it's got that lovely vintage tint to it. It's a C-shaped neck, and so it's kind of vintage feeling, but not too thick. It's not like an old original Esquire. What is lovely and vintage, though, are the narrow, tall frets. So this guitar has 21 narrow, tall frets. So they're skinny, but quite tall, so you can really dig into the note. 9.5-inch radius Laurel fingerboard as well. And it's just kind of, it's just, the fit and finish is beautiful. Squires always come from the factory perfectly set up, and there's no sharp frets or anything. And what's cool about the FSR stuff is the fact that you can get essentially like a custom shop bespoke Fender guitar for not a lot of money, because it's a Squier. And it still technically does say Fender on the headstock, just very, very small. So, what's the crack with an Esquire? If it looks like a Telecaster, feels like a Telecaster, and quacks like a Telecaster, it should be a Telecaster, right? No, wrong. Like I said before, the Esquire came before the Telecaster, well, the Broadcaster and then the Telecaster, and it only has one pickup. It has one pickup in the bridge. I love single pickup guitars because when there's more than one pickup, even when those pickups aren't activated, the magnets are still pulling on the strings ever so slightly. But with one pickup, you get that entire string vibrating solely for that one pickup, and you just get the purest sound. And that's always been very prevalent on Esquires. They've got a very unique, pokey, honkiness, all the guitar daft words, that just doesn't sound like anything else. But why is there a pickup switch down here? So this is a volume and a tone control, like traditional Telecasters, but this switch, down in what would be the bridge position is the bridge pickup, as you'd expect, but there's no tone control. So this goes from the pickup to the volume to the output jack. The tone doesn't do anything. When it's in the middle position, you activate that tone. So you can use the tone control, and it does alter the sound ever so slightly. You might be able to hear it through YouTube. If not, you've got to come into a PMT store and hear it for yourselves. Like, check this out for comparison. First with no tone, then with tone. ¶¶ play. You get the gist. So it kind of rolls some of the high end off ever so slightly, just the nature of the tone going through that tone circuit, but it means you can do fun stuff like this. And it kind of gives you a faux neck pickup. What is in the neck position, what is usually the neck pickup, bypasses the tone control again, but this actually gives you a capacitor, which is a treble roll-off. So it does sound different than just having the tone control rolled off. So I'll go from bridge to neck. So this guitar, well, Esquires in general, were from the 1950s, and neck pickups are really common now. That was a bad example. Really common now. But they weren't in the 50s, so this is just an extra tonal option you could get on an Esquire back then, before the Telecaster was a thing, and they've continued it through because it has its own unique place in guitar history to the Squier Custom Telecaster. For comparison, this is the tone roll down in position 2 against the treble roll off of position 3. With the tone roll down, there's a lot more low end happening because of the nature of the way tone capacitors work. But with the treble roll off, there's less low end, but it still sounds muffled. It was kind of akin to, I think they were claiming it's like more of a bass guitar kind of tone in the neck position. But that in the full bridge position, it just absolutely screams, folks. Some clean tones now. That same bridge pickup. Esquires always have the nicest kind of tone roll off to do stuff like that with. All that is a wah, you know. All a wah pedal is a tone control. It goes very quick, so you kind of can go. It's not a very usable sound in 2021, but as a guitar lover, I'm really pleased they've kept it. Just because it puts a smile on your face. You're never going to use it, but it's just... Or comment down below where you would use it and where I'm wrong in the fact that you use it for X, Y, and Z. I don't know, it's just really fun to play. We'll be right back. bit less output, isn't there, as well? Less so with a driven sound. That bridge pickup just screams, though. I missed that 20-second fret. So, ladies and gentlemen, I think that's all the sights, specs, and sounds I can get out of the, apologies, very fingerprinty, Squier FSR Fender Special Run 60's Custom Esquire. A guitar after my own heart for not a lot of money. I've never owned an Esquire, and I might just have to buy this one. I've been using Tuatec cables into a Daddario chromatic pedal tuner, into the Blackstar HG Stage Mark II head and cab. You guys are hearing it through a Torpedo Captor X, which has an IR of a Blackstar cabin, going into a Zoom thing and then into your lovely ears. If you want to add anything that I've missed about the Esquire history, or anything cool about that neck pickup tone, that you want to add, please comment down below, because I want to learn more and more about this guitar that I'm probably going to go downstairs and buy. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMT for UK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on this beautiful Squier Custom Esquire FSR 60's Telecaster, not a Telecaster, it's an Esquire, in any of its variants, or any Squier or Fender for that matter, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of this with nice filters on. We're also on TikTok as well. I've been Dagan. I'll see you next time.